Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I often get asked this time of year, when is Eid al-Fitr? Well, I know you need to know to book time off work, get time off for the children at school, college or university, and make your preparations and shopping. So through this video, I'll set out what the three methods are, when we expect the announcements, and what my thoughts are about the respective announcements. Right, first, let me show you the three methods. The first, let's call it the Saudi method. Saudi Arabia follows something called the Umm al-Qura calendar. It's a 50-year calendar based on scientific data from the Royal Greenwich Observatory, which is on the birth of the moon. So they say once the data, the sign says the moon has been born, that should be sufficient to start and end a month. As you can see on the screen now, that calendar is published and they generally tend to stick to that calendar. So that's the Saudi method. The second method is the Morocco or South Africa method. It's also popular amongst many of the Muslim countries around the world, which is based on local moon sighting. So within their respective territorial borders, they will go out and look for the moon. If they receive a positive sighting and it's in line with the science and the observatory reports that the moon can be visible, they accept that based on the Shahada and will announce the end or start of the respective Islamic month. So that's the second method. Again, lots of mosques and Islamic institutes and organizations here in the United Kingdom often follow Morocco or South Africa. The third method, which is getting really popular amongst young British Muslims, and it's spearheaded by the New Crescent Society and many other ulama and Islamic organizations, is local moon sighting, a British solution to moon wars. This is basically go out across the United Kingdom's territorial borders and look for the moon in the United Kingdom. Do not wait for announcements from Morocco, South Africa, Pakistan, India, Saudi Arabia, or any other country around the world. If you find and you see the moon, great. Complete your month and the next day is your Eid, for example. If you don't see the moon, then all you have to do is complete your 30 days and then have your Eid. And you don't take any decoration, any sighting from anywhere else in the world. So that's a British solution spearheaded by the New Crescent Society. So they're the three methods. Now let's show you once again the image of the Umm al-Qura calendar from Saudi Arabia. Again, based on the birth of the moon. So we expect on Thursday the 20th of April, an announcement from the Saudi government that a moon has been sighted and therefore Eid al-Fitr will be on Friday the 21st of April. As you can see on the screen there, that's part of their calendar, their 50-year calendar, which predicts the date for the 21st of April. The only slight problem with that, let's pop image two on the screen. The only problem with that is if you look at the top image, you will see that the moon is impossible to be seen anywhere in the world apart from the margins of America and Canada. They're in the west, so it doesn't apply in terms of the east, in terms of their announcement. So the moon is impossible to be seen on the Thursday, the day Saudi Arabia will announce Eid for the Friday. Now, Morocco and South Africa will also attempt to look for the moon on Thursday the 20th. They will make announcements that the moon has not been seen. Look at the image again at the top of the screen, which shows you the moon is impossible to be seen on Thursday night. They will make an announcement that they will complete their 30 days. And therefore, either Morocco and South Africa will be Saturday, the 22nd of April. In terms of local moon sighting here in the United Kingdom, they also will look out for the moon on the Thursday. Remember, we all started Ramadan together. This is why everything's in line. It'll be the 29th of Ramadan. They will go out and look for the moon. They will not see the moon in the United Kingdom. That image again, top image. And therefore, they will complete the 30 days. And their announcement will be Eid, Saturday the 22nd of April. Let me just put that image back on the screen. The second image is the moon sighting, or the potential for a positive sighting, on the Friday. And you can see all the green. The green demonstrates that the moon is visible, even by the naked eye, pretty much all over the world. And therefore, that is in line with moon sighting. So there are the three methods. Now, unless Saudi Arabia make a massive U-turn, which they very rarely do, but it's possible, they will stick to their predicted Eid date on their Umm al-Qura calendar and have Eid on Friday the 21st of April. Saudi Arabia, won't move from that, I predict. Morocco and South Africa will obviously stick to completing the 30 days based on the science and then no positive sighting. Again, Pakistan, India, Bangladesh follow similar methods. They will not see the moon on the Thursday evening. They will complete the 30 days. Their Eid will also be on the Saturday, the 22nd. So I hope that gives you an indication of my predictions. Obviously, we won't get any announcement until Thursday evening. In some cases, we've already seen some countries, New Zealand and some in the United States already make that announcement. But on the whole, countries and Muslim institutes here in the United Kingdom will wait until Thursday, the 20th of April. And I will, like I have in previous years, be tweeting. So you can follow me on Twitter, mshafiqUK, for the latest updates on Thursday evening. But as I said, I suspect and expect, my prediction is that Saudi Arabia will announce Eid Thursday evening for Friday, the 21st of April, and South Africa, Morocco, and pretty much the rest of the countries will announce Eid for Saturday, the 22nd. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoy the video. Please do post your comments and your feedback. And I hope you found it useful. Assalamu alaikum.